This is a tire iron, and this is what you're going to be using to take the tire off, but not to put the tire back on. This end is a hook that's going to go under the spoke, and you'll see in a few minutes how that's used. And this end here is really the business end of the tire iron. This is the end that actually gets pushed underneath the tire and used to lever the tire right off of the rim. So if you buy tire irons, make sure that this end of it is pretty slender. If it's too thick, it's difficult to get under the tire and it'll make you nuts. All tire irons are definitely not created equal. Okay, now let's get the tire off. I'm just going to take my thumb and peel this back a little bit and put one of these tire irons in. Normally you're going to need about two or three of these to get it going. I'm just going to let the tire hold that in place. I'm going to pull back another little section of casing here and work this in. And now see, I just pushed the tire irons down like that and they flip the casing off. This tire iron here, now you can see how I've used the hooked end. I've just put it right around the spoke, right here. Now I'm going to keep working this off a little bit more. All right, so now you can see I have two of the tire irons on here in place like this. And I've got enough of the casing on here now where I really should be able to just get this off with my fingers. I just kind of start pulling this off. Yeah, see, here comes the whole thing off now. Now I'm at the valve stem. Let me back around to the other side here and work the tire off this way. I'm just doing this with my hands. It's nice and easy, no problem at all. All right, so there we go. We've got this off, and you can actually just take, if you want, the entire tire at this point and remove the entire thing from the rim. See? Pretty straightforward, huh? Now all I've got is a rim, a tire, and an inner tube. Now all we have to do is get this stuff back together again. All right, to get this back on, let's just take the tire and get one side of it on the rim. I'm going to start here at the valve hole just as a starting point. I just want to get this one side on. I'm going to have to pick it up like this. I'm just working it on with my hands here. Just that one single side. It's going to be a little bit tough when I get right here at the end. I've got to work it just a little bit. But now, one side is off. This side is completely off still. The other side's on. Now let's get the inner tube back in. All right, now I've got the inner tube. If you ever watch my video on what I carry in my saddlebag, you'll know that I carry my inner tube in a bag with powder in it, and you can actually see the powder on this tube. It just makes it go in a little bit easier. Let's start right here again. Here's the valve hole. Let's take this and get it inserted like that. And then what we want to do is just work this in place. So I'm going to go around the whole tire and I'm going to get this inner tube in where it should be. With it. Sometimes it's easier just to... I usually do this sitting in an entirely different position, not standing in front of a video camera, so I'm a little out of sorts here. But you can see what I'm doing. I'm just getting this inner tube worked in all the way around. Voila. Inner tube is now in place. Now, let's come back up here to the beginning and let's start getting the casing of the tire in. I'm going to take the valve and just push this up here to get the inner tube in here and out of the way. I'm working my way around here. Every once in a while I'll see a little bit of inner tube starting to kind of come through. I'll just take my fingers and stuff it back up. Stuff, stuff, stuff. So, you know, you really want to make sure too, again, push this, make sure all the air is out of here. Take a look here. I don't have a whole lot more. I'm down to the bare bones here. This is all I've got left to get back in. And this is where it's starting to get tough because I've got an inner tube crammed in here, trying to get everything pulled together. This is where you'll be tempted to grab the tire iron and use it, boom, to lever the tire back on. Do not do that. Use your thumbs like this. Now, See that inner tube? It's in the way a little bit here. It's making life a little bit harder, but bonk, there we go. Now, I got the whole thing back on again. Just like that, no top tools at all. If you use tools to try and get the casing back on, what you're going to do is puncture the tube. You'll have two little pinpoints, two little snake eyes. You'll start pumping it up, the air comes up, it's all been in vain. What I normally do at this point now is I'll pump this tire up to maybe 40 pounds or so, then I'll let all the air back out of it. The theory behind that being that that gives the tube a chance to expand, to get all the wrinkles and stuff out of it, and to kind of assume its normal position within the tire. I don't know if that's true or not. A friend of mine owned a bike shop told me that. He also told me pump it up to 40 pounds and then bump it gently on the ground like this to let everything get back into place. Does that work? I don't know. Been doing it for years, never had a problem with the tire yet. Anyway, do that, then I pump it up to full pressure. When you're done, make sure that you tighten the little valve cap there and that you put on the little washer if you had one of those, like this bike does. And of course that you get the cap on the valve stem. Another thing too when you're done to make sure of is that this valve stem points directly towards the hub. If it's cocked this way or cocked that way, the inner tube is in crooked, and you may well get a flat right where the inner tube has its valve right here. So this should be pointing dead center down here. Just be patient with this. Sometimes it's hard to do the first time. My advice, though, is if you've never done it before, do it before you need to do it, and then you'll know what you're doing.